Hey folks, this is IoEther, and we're back playing some more World of Tanks. So this time we got Dewar in his AMX 5100, and I might just start calling it the Picasso, because I mean, look at that paint job. This is a D-rate game on Himmelsdorf. I actually really like that paint job somehow. Anyways. So the 5100 is an auto-loading heavy. So that means once he's done with his six shots, he really does need to extract himself from battle for like a minute to reload. So that should be interesting to see how he works that into his play. Okay. Oh, got shot alright. Good job. Now this thing is a medium, effectively, except for the fact that it has the armor or the health pool of a heavy tank. And it dishes out damage like a heavy tank. Other than that, it's fast, it's horribly, horribly armored. Can fire off a burst of damage, and it's quite accurate. Thus, medium tank. Oh, that poor Panther. Yeah, he got out of there at the right time. Two more shots and he would have been dead. So you can see Dewar is trying to use this thing for side scraping. It's actually a really effective way to use his armor because of the fact that it has no frontal armor and very little side armor. But when side scraping, that doesn't really matter because he's at an auto bounce angle. Unless, that Cromwell. Oh, he dodged the right way. Anyways, because the angle he's at, unless somebody shoots him in the front of his hull, which is a very tight shot to make, most shots are just going to bounce straight off him. Now, he's not going to want to face an IS-3, but a Cromwell, he can kill a Cromwell very easily. Oh, that is not a Cromwell. That's an ISU-152. I was about to say, if that thing hits him, he'll regret it. It hit him, so yeah, he's definitely regretting getting hit by that. There goes half of his health. So, now he's in trouble. Now you will notice that there is no other tanks on this side of the map. There is an ISU and a Hellcat guarding the base. There is a Crusader SP that is back there setting up. And nothing else. So, somehow an autoloader managed to try to hold an entire flank all by himself. Now, he's going to have some serious trouble doing that. This Cromwell is taking him apart because he's not loaded, because he can't reload. Oh, a few seconds more, and there we go. He is reloaded now, but he still has to get out of there. He has enough health that most things in this game can one-shot him, with the exception of like that Cromwell that would have to two-shot him. Most of the tier 6s would have to put two shots into him. Never mind. I was looking at the wrong team and didn't realize that. The only thing on the enemy team that wouldn't be able to one shot him is the Cromwell. Everything else can do enough damage to kill him in one shot. So, he's trying to find a suitable position to defend from. He knows the Cromwell's going after the Crusader, so he set up an ambush and used the Crusader's bait. I'm thinking he probably didn't want the Crusader to die, but, you know, sometimes the bait dies. That's what happens in a trap. Ooh, Kinesi, yes, nice shot. No possible way the ISU can shoot back at him because of the stuff that's in the way. Ooh, look at the damage he can dish out. Now that shot was either lucky or experience, one of the two. He shot through terrain, but that particular bit of terrain didn't have a hitbox, so this rigged game sucks. You notice how the losing team always says stuff like that? How does that work? You're losing. You didn't play smart. That means what? Why is there a Hellcat back there? Anyways, whatever. He's not dead yet, but he still just decides that this game sucks. You know, he's about to be dead, come on. Nope, never mind. That IS-3 is going to be trouble. Unless somebody can get it. Well, Mr. Lo, if those are your feelings, then how about you just stop playing the game? The rest of us would gladly enjoy it if you just stop playing. Yeah, it would make our lives so much nicer. So now, thankfully, that he has teammates who came back to help him hold him aside. And they're just trying to pull this IS-3 out into the open. They want it to fire, and it did. And so now they're just going to run in and murder him. And no, one. There we go. ISU takes the killing blow, and there's just an SU-152 over fighting off a Churchill 7. And let's spin this around. Yeah, so the Churchill 7 should be able to win this battle. Of course, one half decent shot from the SU would have killed it, but nope, saved by the AMX-5100. 1500 experience and the sniper medal for that great game. He fired 13 shots and hit 14, and 92.86% hit. That, of course, earned him the sniper. That's a great mod he's got, and I'm not particularly sure where he got it, but I like it. Came away with 3,470 total damage for a base experience of 1,000, which means he wasn't quite on top of the board, but he was darn close to it. The only thing with more was the VK 3602D, which of course is a tier 7 tank, which is why it earned more experience for less damage. Oh well, right? Killed 3 tanks, but dished out a whole bunch of damage, and held the enemy team back, while the rest of his team was charging off down one flank in a lemming train that somehow managed to push past the enemy team. Duer held an entire side by himself. He was against 4 or 5 tanks, and didn't just run away scared. He put as many shots into them as possible, held them in place as long as possible, and only moved when he absolutely had to move in order to save his own life. And then he used the Crusader's bait, of course, which was hilarious. Though I guess the Crusader probably didn't think so. Oh well. You'll see that every single shot that he hit went in. That's the amazing penetration of this gun. He received 2,175 potential damage. That was more damage than he would like to have taken. A lot of that was from the side scraping he did. Anytime you see somebody side scraping, be really hesitant about whether or not you should be firing these shots, because most of the time you're just giving people steel walls. HE doesn't matter if you don't think you're going to do anything but bounce off. Don't bother firing the shot. Wait till he does something stupid like pull backwards in order to get a shot on you, and then put one into his lure Glacius. Best way to take out a side scraper. That, or track him and go around him. That'll work too. Now you see, he had some sort of event going on that gained him extra credits, so he walked away with almost as much as he actually made in, you know, for the game, just based on repair costs and everything like that. For 6 minutes of work, 46 grand earned. Totally worth it. Thank you so much, Duer, for sending this in. This shows everybody what one tank holding a side can do, because without him, this would have been a loss. It would have been a quick and easy victory for the enemy, and they would have capped us out before our team could have done anything to respond. Thank you so much for watching and hitting that like or subscribe button. I will see you guys next time. This is IOE Threat.